Guys, I've been trying to do this forever, but recently I finally achieved my lifelong goal of becoming a millionaire. Yep, that's right. I officially have $1 million in my bank account, and I even brought an employee from Chase Bank headquarters to back up my claim, so nobody thinks that I'm lying. Here he is. People from Chase Bank are actually really tiny.
Yep.
So anyway, yes, I have $1 million, Michael can confirm, but you're probably wondering how I did this. How did I become a millionaire? Well, I came up with an idea that changed the world from the inside out. Let me tell you how it all started. This is the story of how I came up with the next $1 million business idea. And as always, this is a real story. Everything that happened is completely and totally true.
Oh my God! Michael! Michael!
This day started like any other. I broke my alarm clock like a superhero, then bought a new one on eBay with express shipping. Okay, now I'm ready to start the day. It was just about time for work, so I packed my briefcase, made myself a turkey sandwich, and left the house. Recently, I got a new job, and today was my first day. But I still wasn't sure what the job was. My boss just said it was kind of like the Office TV show, except no Jim and no Pam. But there would be cameras watching our every move. So I arrived at work and entered the building. It was completely empty. And I was the first person there. Thank goodness for that though, because soon my primal urges took over and I found myself running around the room like a kid at the candy store. I rolled around and jumped as high as I could until I tired myself out. Man, that was fun. Before I knew it, other people started to arrive. First was a man of tall stature. He looked down at me and said, "Welcome to work." I said, "Thank you, sir. Could I get your name?" He said, "Charles. Charles Darwin." Now, I wanted to ask if he was the guy who made natural selection, but maybe that was a little too personal for my first day. Next came a woman who looked really cool and full of spunk. I tried to wave to her, but she just kept on walking. Now that's cool. Finally, my boss arrived, the guy who hired me. He came up to me, reached out his fist, and said, "Bro fist." Okay, I think I'm gonna like this place. I bumped his fist, and then we all sat in a tiny circle on the ground. My boss stood up and said, "Hello, welcome to work." Everybody clapped.
"Everyone, please introduce yourself to our new hire. I'll go first. Hi, Ben. I'm Jack Daniels, the guy from the whiskey bottle."
"What?"
"Hey, Ben. I'm Victoria, the one with a secret."
"Oh my gosh."
"Hello, we've already met, but I'm Charles Darwin."
"Don't say it."
"The guy who made natural selection."
"No way!"
I was overcome with shock, and as I opened my eyes wide with surprise, I noticed one single cameraman in the corner of the room, zooming in on me. My boss looked at me and said,
"Let me explain. We three are titans of the industry, and we're looking for a new venture. But we need someone different. Someone with a bunch of crazy ideas. And that's you."
When I was in the interview, I didn't bring a resume or anything. I don't even have one. I just came in, dressed my best, and started listing off ideas. Here's some more I've had recently. Dog with a social security number. Credit card with a personality. Permanent math teacher? My boss held his finger firm in my direction. "Are you up to the task?" I pretended to think for a second to create suspense for the camera. And after an appropriate amount of time, I said yes. We all sat back down and Jack Daniels went over the game plan.
All right, we've got a meeting with some investors the day after tomorrow. So for the next 24 hours, we are gonna go camping in the woods. We're gonna stay up as long as it takes and not have any food or water until we think of the perfect idea.
Everyone was in agreement. And next thing you know, we were in a plane about to jump out into the woods in an undisclosed location. I was scared and my heart was beating fast. I really didn't know if I could do this. But in my darkest moment, Charles Darwin looked me in the eyes and said, "This will be natural selection at its finest." And this actually just made me more scared. So I looked to Victoria for advice. She put her sunglasses on and striked a cool pose. What is life without a couple of secrets? Okay, that wasn't really applicable here. It was almost time to jump and my heartbeat was only becoming more irregular. I looked to Jack Daniels with one final plea. He could see I was worried, so he reached into his pants pocket and pulled out a full bottle of Jack Daniels.
"Drink this!"
And with no options left, I took the bottle and drank the whole thing in one gulp. I woke up next to a campfire. The stars were shining and the moon was full. I got up and asked what happened.
"You passed out, man! And only after one bottle of Daniels!"
"One time I drank 10 bottles of this stuff in under 5 minutes, and I didn't even feel anything. Maybe it's just because I've been drinking it so long. I actually made this drink when I was a baby. I don't know how people usually make alcohol, but I just mixed a bunch of stuff together and made a little concoction, and it's been the same recipe ever since. Also, don't worry, my parents didn't let me drink the concoction until I was 21. But once I finally got my hands on it, that's all I ever drank. I haven't had water in years."
I asked everybody how long I was out. They said 4 hours. So I guess we've got 20 hours left. The grind starts now. Jack Daniels split us into two groups and told us to go on a thinking walk. Victoria and I walked away from the others and started brainstorming new ideas. We bounced off each other for a while. New pills that change your age.
Instant haircut.
Travel size airplane.
Dog with a social security number.
No.
I already thought of that.
Who says I didn't think of it first? So me and Victoria started to fight. With our words, but also with our hands. And before we knew it, we had lost our way.
Do you know where we are?
No. Do you?
Yes. But I won't tell.
What? I have 1 million secrets. I know everything ever.
But I refuse to tell anyone.
Because then I'd have to be vulnerable. But no, I'm like a living god. I literally know the answer to every question there is. I even know what happens after death. But that's for me to know, and for you to find out, okay? 'Cause I'm not gonna tell you.
Victoria stood there with her head held high and her lips pursed tight. I tried to talk to her, but she refused to make a sound. So I decided to just go off on my own. I waved goodbye and continued walking, hoping I'd somehow find my way back. I thought I was alone, but the cameraman found me and was trailing from behind. I decided to ignore him. It was the middle of the night at this point, and I pretty much couldn't see anything. I just walked and walked until I bumped into what I thought was a tree. It was tall and extremely firm, and also kind of warm. Wait a minute. I opened my eyes a little wider to see that it was Charles Darwin. We exchanged pleasantries and sat down together on a log. Charles started a fire for us.
Charles, weren't you supposed to be with Jack Daniels?
Yes, but he drank so much Jack Daniels that he finally got actually drunk for real. So I brought him back to the campsite and let him rest.
Charles is such a nice guy. I asked him if they came up with any good ideas. He shook his head in disappointment.
Man, at this rate, we're never gonna come up with the next big idea.
Charles looked down with a sadness in his eyes.
You know, I think my time may be over. I've been living for like more than 200 years. And I already came up with natural selection, so I think I've made my mark. But Charles, we promised to come up with something together.
I know, but I believe in you, Ben. You don't need me or Victoria or Jack Daniels or anyone. The next big idea is already in your heart.
Charles held his hand over my chest and then began to float into the sky.
I tried to grab onto him, but he started to become translucent. He floated up and up until his opacity eventually became zero. He was gone.
I guess natural selection finally got him.
And he never even got a talking head segment.
Heaven is real!
I sat there and took in the moment. Did I really have the next big idea already? I felt lost. What am I supposed to do alone?
You're not alone. I looked behind me, and the once silent cameraman had finally opened his mouth. Mr. Cameraman? No, you can call me Mike. Jersey Mike.
The guy who made sandwiches!
Sandwiches were made by one guy? Yep, I made sandwiches. Jersey Mike's was founded in 1956, but I've been alive for thousands of years, possibly even millions.
Way longer than Charles Darwin.
Anyway, I remember being a caveman and making a rock sandwich. The guys back at the cave loved it. And it's been a thing ever since.
But Jersey Mike, what are you doing here? And behind the camera at that? Shouldn't you be a part of this operation?
I used to be, but that was long ago. I was kicked out years ago for trying to make every idea some kind of sandwich. But now I'm back. And with a vengeance.
Jersey Mike put down his camera and started walking towards me with a grin. No. No, this can't be. Evil was amongst us. And now I'm the only one left standing in his way.
Let's see what you're all about, new guy.
I'm gonna steal every idea you have and make it my own.
Then I'll reap the benefits.
No, stay away.
But it was too late. Unbeknownst to me, Jersey Mike had a power. A power to steal what stood before him.
He lifted his hand, and I too began to lift, like Star Wars. And just like that, he started sucking all the ideas out of me.
Oreos, but with gum in the middle. Rat locator. Edible rocks from the ground. Travel size airplane. Sunderpants. Underpants for the sun. New pills that change your age. Permanent math teacher. Death Note, but for bringing people back to life. Credit card with a personality. Crumb generator.
Huh? What's going on here?
But luckily for me, he started to reject them.
No.
There's nothing good here. You're full of nothing but trash. You were a plant. Oh my God. You were a plant to fill me with bad ideas. They must have known. They must have known.
Jersey Mike faded away into nothing, and my brain was left with nothing.
All my ideas had been taken. But that's not all. My world had been shaken.
Is that really all this was? Was everyone lying to me this whole time? Charles Darwin was gone. Jack Daniels was in a Jack Daniels-induced coma. And Victoria? Well, she would never tell me the truth. To this day, I still don't know.
but all I could do was move forward. I went to the big board meeting alone the next day, and luckily, there was one idea left in the recess of my mind that Jersey Mike had forgotten to take. Dog with a social security number. And guys, it was a hit. The executives loved it. We reached out to big brands and also the government, and they immediately funded us. Every dog in the world has a social security number now. I was so happy. And it wasn't because of the millions of dollars I got, no. It was because I proved myself. I proved that I could do it. And even if this was all some sham to trick Jersey Mike, at the end of the day, I won. I came up with the next million-dollar business idea. And I swear to God, Victoria did not think of it first.